I've spent my last 25 years in public service of one kind or another. At the end of another term, I'd be in my mid-80s. Frankly, it's time for a new generation of leaders. They're the ones that need to make the decisions that will shape the world they will be living in.
Senator Mitt Romney will not be seeking re-election. That's the big announcement he made today. And he did so while a giant excerpt of a biography written about him was published in The Atlantic. In that excerpt, there were a lot of jabs at members of his own party, which we'll get to in just a moment. But he really explains that he'd like to kind of retire at this point. He, you know, mentioned how it's now time for a younger generation to take the reins and govern the country and lead it in the direction that makes sense for younger generations. But at the same time, I think that just based on what was written in that excerpt published in The Atlantic, it's clear that the party has changed to a point where he doesn't really feel comfortable within it. And he names names, so I can't wait to get to some of that, including how Republican lawmakers feel about Donald Trump specifically behind the scenes, while pretending like they're huge fans and loyalists of Donald Trump publicly.
So I think there's a couple of reasons for this retirement. We can acknowledge that Mitt Romney would have had a primary. I don't know if it would have been a tough one, probably, but he crushed last time. So I think he would have been fine in the primary. But do you want even a 10% chance of losing if you're Mitt Romney and you were the governor of Massachusetts, you're the senator of Utah, you had this huge business career that in the Washington world is coveted. So retiring on a high note makes tons of sense. And what are you gonna stay there until your 80s for anyway? You're super rich, he should go enjoy his life. So I think he made definitely the right decisions. I think politics entered into it a little bit in terms of that primary. But generally, I know it's a bit shocking for me to say, but I kind of believe him that he just wants to leave well enough alone and go. I've got more on his attack against other Republicans, which I love.
I can't believe his age. I mean, look, politics aside, I know I'm gonna get heat for this, but I gotta call a spade a spade. Is Mitt Romney the original Zaddy?
Yeah.
I can't believe he's as old as he is. And like, by the way, he looks good. He looks good for his age, like unbelievably good for his age.
No, yeah, and you know, there's a common, I don't know if you call it a stereotype or a positive way of looking at it.
That I mean, that's not a good picture.
No, that's not the best one. But that black folks don't age as much as other races do, right? I don't know, Mitt Romney's secretly black, because and it would be the biggest, deepest secret of all time. But that brother does not age. Like, I can't believe how he's in his mid-70s and he looks great. Anyways, but guys, I don't want you guys mistaking anything we're saying for we like Mitt Romney. No, he's a very corporate establishment Republican.
That's why I said politics aside.
Yeah. So those guys like him have been robbing us blind for decades in this country. Now, having said that, that doesn't mean that he isn't right about the other end of the Republican Party. And so Anna's gonna give you the devastating quotes he has against other Republican politicians. And on that, I do appreciate his honesty.
I do.
And he's a very rare politician that had the courage to say, no, my side is full of crap.
Yeah, no.
And I can't take it anymore.
I genuinely do respect him on that front, because I know how difficult it can be to be outspoken and critical of your side when you know they're engaging in behavior that is not good. Okay.
Look, I'll go even further. So we're gonna get to the comments in 1 second. But I don't know that Bernie's ever criticized the Democrat this honestly.
No, he has.
Naming names.
I mean, look, he used to be a lot more ferocious on that front for sure. And he's a little gentler now. And I think it's because he has some say and power, and he has some say over some of the policies, some influence over some of the policies in the Biden administration. But anyway, look, Let's get off the Bernie bashing for a minute, okay? Let's go back to the Republicans.
No, I love Bernie, but they don't they don't get that you have to take on your colleagues in order to accomplish anything. But at least Mitt Romney understands, yes, sometimes you have to be honest about your side, no matter whose feelings get hurt.
So let's get to what Romney had to say about his Republican colleagues. Again, this was a lengthy excerpt of a forthcoming biography about Mitt Romney that's written by McKay Coppins. And here is what Republican senators said about Donald Trump after the Mueller investigation failed to show any evidence of collusion with Russia. Perhaps Romney's most surprising discovery upon entering the Senate was that his disgust with Trump was not unique among his Republican colleagues. Almost without exception, he told me, they shared my view of the president. In public, of course, they played their parts as Trump loyalists, often contorting themselves rhetorically to defend the president's most indefensible behavior. But in private, they ridiculed his ignorance, rolled their eyes at his antics, and made incisive observations about his warped, toddler-like psyche. Romney recalled one senior Republican senator frankly admitting, quote, he has none of the qualities you would want in a president and all the qualities you wouldn't. Now, after the Justice Department announced that the Mueller investigation showed no collusion between Donald Trump and Russia, here's what happened. As Romney later wrote in his journal, the president was met with a standing ovation fit for a conquering hero, and then launched into some rambling remarks. He talked about the so-called Russia hoax and relitigated the recent midterm elections and swung wildly from one tangent to another. He declared, somewhat implausibly, that the GOP would soon become the party of healthcare. The senators were respectful and attentive. As soon as Trump left, Romney recalled, the Republican caucus burst into laughter.
God, I can't stand how dishonest the Republican politicians and right-wing media is. We've said it 2 billion times. We get it. We're not like mainstream media. Democratic politicians are also dishonest. But this is a different level, guys. Mm-hmm. Like, they are Jekyll and Hyde. They don't believe a word they're saying, not a goddamn word. Everybody knows in Washington that Trump is one of the dumbest people to ever step foot in public life. And Romney says it over and over again. Incredibly dumb, incredibly mean, filled with hatred, obsessed with himself, a total con man. Yet, other than Romney, as he's retiring, and to be fair, he said it before he was retiring too. There's like 5 to 10 guys in the history of Trump from the Republican Party, Adam Kinzinger, Liz Cheney, etc., that have had the courage to say, all right, I'll lose my seat. But this isn't right. This isn't right. This guy's is just disgusting in every way. He's a con man, a liar, etc. Every other Republican politician is the worst person on earth, totally brazenly lying to you, and that's one of their own.
So there's a lot more
saying,
to get to.
They say it in private. They say it all the time. They're all goddamn liars.
So we're just scratching the surface. Let's get to McConnell. Let's get to Republican leadership, right? Because McConnell especially despises Donald Trump, and it's not a new phenomenon with McConnell. He has despised Donald Trump for a very long time. In fact, one time during Trump's first impeachment, as the first impeachment was underway, essentially, Trump attacked Romney on Twitter because Romney called Trump's actions wrong and appalling. This was the impeachment having to do with Trump withholding congressionally appropriated funds to Ukraine in return for a sham investigation announcement by Volodymyr Zelensky. Now, McConnell privately called Trump and asked him to stop attacking members of the Senate. And then Romney called McConnell to thank him for doing that. But apparently, this was McConnell's response to Romney as he was thanking him. It wasn't for you so much as for him, McConnell replied. He's an idiot. He doesn't think when he says things. How stupid do you have to be to not realize you shouldn't attack your jurors? And then he continues, you're lucky, McConnell continued. You can say the things that we all think. You're in a position to say things about him that we all agree with, but can't say. Now, a spokesperson said that McConnell does not recall this conversation. And that he was fully aligned with Trump during the impeachment trial. And
coward.
There's one other element of McConnell that's worth mentioning. So it has to do with the riots that took place on January 6th. About 4 days prior to the riots taking place on January 2nd of 2021, Mitt Romney gets a text message from Angus King. So at that point, Angus King is a junior senator, and King says to call him because he has something important to say. King informs Mitt Romney of a conversation he just had with a high-ranking Pentagon official. Law enforcement has been tracking online chatter among right-wing extremists who appear to be planning something bad on the day of Donald Trump's upcoming rally in Washington, D.C. The president has been telling me the election was stolen. Now they're coming to steal it back. There's talk of gun smuggling, of bombs and arson, of targeting the traitors in Congress who are responsible for this travesty. Romney's name has been popping up in some frightening corners of the internet, which is why King needed to talk to him. He isn't sure Romney will be safe. So at that point, Romney talks to him, Romney gets the info, he calls or he sends text messages to Mitch McConnell to basically warn him about what he has heard. And this is what he wrote. In case you have not heard this, I just got a call from Angus King, who said that he had spoken with a senior official at the Pentagon, who reports that they are seeing very disturbing social media traffic regarding the protests planned on January 6th. There are calls to burn down your home, Mitch, to smuggle guns into DC and to storm the Capitol. I hope that sufficient security plans are in place, but I am concerned that the instigator, the president, is the one who commands the reinforcements the DC and Capitol Police might require. And guess what McConnell did in response to those text messages? Nothing. He didn't even respond.
Yep. They're all scared of Trump. And by the way, even if you're a Republican, you got to respect Romney way more than you respect all those other establishment Republicans.
I certainly do. Yeah.
And you know, and why? And you know this, even if you're MAGA, you hate Romney, no problem. I get it, brother. But at least he's being honest, and you can tell, right? And you know Mitch McConnell's dishonest. You know every one of these guys, J.D. Vance, we're going to get to him in a second. Liars, total utter filthy liars. And even if you're a Republican, you know that. They hate your beloved Trump. They hate him. And they think he's an idiot. And they never say it. They never say it because they're cowards and they're craven and they're corrupt.
Now, before we get to J.D. Vance and Mitt Romney doesn't pull any punches, I do want to just share a quick little excerpt on Mike Pence, because apparently Romney had long been put off by Pence's pious brand of Trump sycophancy. No one, he told me, has been more loyal, more willing to smile when he saw absurdities, more willing to ascribe God's will to things that were ungodly than Mike Pence.
Yeah, look, all politicians are, almost all politicians are like this. Mike Pence is like, oh God, I care so much about God. And then Trump does like these demonic things. And Pence is like, God's in favor of it, sure. Is that godly, Mike? Is it? But all that being said, he did not participate in the coup. And for that, he's gonna go down in history as a guy at the most critical moment did the right thing. So Mike Pence, I'm past it. J.D. Vance, on the other hand, I'm not past at all.
So in regard to J.D. Vance, as Romney surveyed the crop of Republicans running for Senate in 2022, it was clear that more Josh Hawleys were on their way. Perhaps most disconcerting was J.D. Vance, the Republican candidate in Ohio. I don't know that I can disrespect someone more than J.D. Vance, Romney told me.
Yeah, I mean, Anna's known as a salt dragon. But I mean, Mitt Romney, I did not know was salt daddy.
No, listen. This is what, this actually not only made me respect Romney, again, we disagree politically, but I respect his integrity, that he wants to stay true to his values. And more importantly, he is carrying out what I hope to one day be able to do myself. As he's making his exit, he takes the blowtorch. Here's what I really think about all of you.
I know. I thought Mormons were supposed to be.
Wait for it.
Well, I thought you were doing that on a daily basis anyway. Okay.
Kind of.
But I thought Mormons were supposed to be like nice and pleasant. Instead, this guy comes in with a blowtorch of salt.
Amazing.
Finally, Vance.
Yes, and so, by the way, he actually used to like J.D. Vance prior to J.D. Vance running for Senate. He read Hillbilly Elegy, he thought Vance was a great guy. But as soon as he started running as a candidate for the United States Senate, obviously he became more and more Trumpian in order to appeal to the MAGA base. And so here's what else Romney had to say about him. I do wonder, how do you make that decision? Romney mused as Vance was degrading himself on the campaign trail that summer. How do you go over a line so stark as that? And for what? It's like, really? You sell yourself so cheap? The prospect of having Vance in the caucus made Romney uncomfortable. How do you sit next to him at lunch?
Yeah. Yeah,
I love it. I welcome this. I welcome all of this. I will allow it. It's great.
Okay, and I'm gonna give you one more caveat. Look, to be fair to Romney, he sells himself more expensively, and so he's been doing the bidding of corporate donors and the establishment for a long, long time, and that's a more sophisticated robbery. But it and one more caveat. You remember when Trump was thinking of making him Secretary of State? All of a sudden, Mitt Romney didn't hate Trump as much, okay? So let's acknowledge all of that. Now, having said that, the J.D. Vances of the world are the most disgusting liars I've ever met. And I appreciate that Mitt Romney, even though he's in the same party as him, acknowledges. No, it's almost a form of breaking the gaslighting and breaking the torture that is gaslighting. He's like, no, your eyes aren't lying to you. The guy's a total scumbag. And he doesn't believe anything he's saying. Mm-hmm. He hated Trump. He thought Trump was an idiot. He all of those things, and then turns around and lodges himself right in Trump's ass. And everything he says is a lie.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.